Some dogs come as natural retrievers, and sometimes you don't know what you've got until you try. When I get a puppy, I like to teach them to come when they're called, and have good name recognition, and to do enough training that they understand that good means they're good, and means they should try something different. And as soon as I have a decent recall, I want to see what I can do with the retrieve. So what I'm going to do is start by making the dumbbell interesting to them. Ready? What's that? What's that? And we want them interested with their mouths, not necessarily with their feet. Ready? What's that? Oh, good job. That was good. Oh, good boy. Very nice. Good job. And I'm not going to be in a big hurry to get it away from him when he grabs it. Ready? Ready? Yes, good boy. Because with this level of game, I'm interested in getting the dog intrigued by the dumbbell. Ready? Ready? Yes, excellent boy. Good job. Very good boy. And I'm going to move away from him and encourage him to chase me with it. Atta boy. Good. And he is doing a hold, but if he had dropped it, as long as he had grabbed it, that's what I need first, is the grab. Now, he's pretty revved up about this. You can see that I did not throw it to the ground because I don't want to encourage him to pounce. But once I can get the dog to voluntarily grab the dumbbell, then any other teaching that I have to do is pretty easy because his attitude about the dumbbell itself is easy. Now, some dogs are just not interested in the dumbbell itself, but if they're interested in food, you can convince them to be interested in the dumbbell. And today I've got just little jerky treats. What I'm going to do is hold it on the bell, or the bar rather, and encourage him to approach. With a dog that was worried about getting towards your hand, you could put a little bit of squeeze cheese on there, and that keeps the bell clear for the dog to get his nose where you need it to be. It's a better choice. Once the dog will approach the dumbbell voluntarily, then what I want to do is encourage him, yes, to approach the dumbbell without the food on it, but I'm going to bring the food to it. Ready? Ready? Yes. Oh, good job. And of course, he knows this, so you are seeing a little bit of grab behavior. You're not necessarily going to see that the first couple of sessions with a brand new retriever, unless you've gotten them to play with it before. Once he will approach to it, I'm going to work a little bit with different heights. So I might lower it down. Yes. Good boy. Excellent. Good boy. The next time, where'd it go? Where is it? Ready? Yes. Very good. And a lot of times when you bring it up over their head, that's when you get the very first grab. Once you get a grab, you don't reward anything less than the grab when you're in a familiar training place. But when you take the dog out to train elsewhere, you might have to go back to the very beginning of just rewarding them for touching it. But my main thing with, yes, good, whatever you're working on, when you do the rewards, bring the reward to the dumbbell so the dog's very clear that the dumbbell is the mechanism. Otherwise, if you do this, what you're doing is rewarding them for moving away from the dumbbell. And pretty soon it gets to the point where some dogs will ignore the dumbbell. So I want to keep the interest in the dumbbell itself. Ready? Yes. Good boy. Very good. Yes. That's right. Good job. Very nice. Okay. Now you will have to get the dog so that he will get his mouth on the dumbbell when you bring it to the ground. Do that in stages. Ready? Yes. Good boy. And when he picks it, grabs it, I'm going to put my hand under it so that it lands in my hand. Yes. Good job. Now he's actually lifting it. Some dogs at first are going to just put their mouths on it and let go right away, and I still want the hand there to capture it. Yes. Good boy. Oops, too bad. Yes. Excellent boy. And right there we had a chance to see the rule that we're working up to, which is it has to land in my hand in order to make the treats happen. Once they learn that rule, it's okay if they drop it, because all you do is say, well, too bad, doesn't work, keep the hand there. Yes. Whoops. Too bad. Yes. Excellent. And pretty soon they'll practically be shoving it in your hand. And that's the first step to a shaped hold.